This is not a way that we see business done a lot in the mixed martial arts world, to see promotions working together. Why does this make sense to you to do business this way?
まあ2015年にライジンがスタートして3年半ですけども、まあ、僕らはフェデレーションをというプロモーションではなくてフェデレーションという構想を持っていて、とにかくこの産業を3つ回せがつって産業がこれからさらに伸びていくためには、もうプロモーションの中の順位決定戦ではなくて、プロモーションを飛び越えて本当に世界一、誰が強いんだ、その階級の中でね、そういうことを決めていけるような、なんかそういうアクションをこのスポーツの中で取る必要がある。だから僕らは、まあ、負けることを恐れずにチャンピオン同士を戦わせるってことを、まあ、昔から なんか僕の友達でもあって尊敬するスコットに話をして、恐れずにチャレンジしようということになって、実現しました。
So initially when we started in 2015, the whole idea was to have a federation, to not have fighters compete within one organization, to determine who's number one within the organization, but to deliver what the fans want to see, who's number one in the world. So that was the initial idea, and for us, we need to challenge and we need to go out there and take some risk, and don't fear the risks behind sending a champion over to fight a champion. And that was the idea. So I Sakagura-san brought up the idea to a longtime friend, Mr. Scott Coker, and that's how everything got started.
I gotta ask, were there nerves when it happened? When you're watching your guy go against the other guy, is there a special feeling of concern or nerves?
まあ、ファンもそうだと思うんですね。ファンも多分その団体を背負ったり、あとはナショナリズムで国を背負ったりってこともそうだと思うし、プロモーター同士もワクワクもするけど、やっぱり勝てば嬉しいし、負ければやっぱり悔しいと思うし、まあ、でもそれがこのスポーツにとってとっても大事なエッセンス、成功するためのエッセンスだと思うんで、ファンがワクワクしてもらう、それと同時にプロモーターもワクワク、ドキドキ、ハラハラします。それがキーだと思います。
I think we have the same nerves as the fans. A lot of fans would definitely pick a side and obviously cheer for their nation, for their country, fighters for their country. But as a promoter, there's definitely a lot of things that go through your mind when you're fighting, when the fighters are fighting. So I think whatever the fans want is what the promoters should deliver.
Do you think cross-promoting is healthy for the MMA industry? And if so, would you like to see more, not only with Bellator, but with other promotions as well?
お互いにとってそれぞれの国、僕らはまあ日本がメインの国でね、だから今回でも多分ベラトールをこれまで見てなかった日本の多くのファンが、総合格闘技のファン、スポーツのファンがベラトールのその大会を見ることになると思います。それをダゾーンを通して見ることになると思いますし、逆にベラトールで今回僕らね、ライジンのファイターでトップのレナとか堀口が出ることでライジンということを知ってもらうことになる。これはお互いにとってとってもいいクロスプロモーションになると思います。
Yeah, well, I do believe that cross promoting is a fantastic thing for the sport, and for both sides. Obviously, a lot of Japanese people will be introduced to Bellator through DAZN because of this fight, and we do believe that a lot of Americans or people watching the zone will be introduced to Ryzen and Ryzen fighters because of this possibility. So overall, yes, it's definitely beneficial for both parties, and it's definitely a healthy thing for this industry.
Have you and Scott spoken about the potential for a Ryzen versus Bellator tournament?
もちろんこれ別に堀口とかレナに限ったことじゃないんでね、団体対団体でどんどん選手を積極的にチャンピオン同士がクロスしてお互いトレードしてっていうか交換していきますから、最終的には本当にベラトール対ライジンの団体の威信というかね、それぞれのプロモーションというかチームの威信をかけたそういう全面対抗戦っていうのができたらいいと思います。
Yeah, the idea is, the idea is not to stop here with Reyna and Horiguchi. The idea is to continue to interact and incentivize one another. So eventually, if we continue that, it would probably lead to something more like a fighters representing their organization on one side, and the other side would be representing the other. So eventually, it'll probably lead there. But right now, it's just the beginning. But eventually, there's something to be looked at.
If Horiguchi wins, he has both belts. Is the plan for him to defend both belts in both organizations?
そうです。だから堀口は忙しくなると思います。
Yes.
この場で言っておきますけど、堀口が勝ちます。
I believe that Horiguchi is going to get busy. He's going to become busy because he's going to win.
Which one would
he have to keep two belts day after tomorrow. Because I guarantee Horiguchi will win.
Guaranteed.
Yeah.
Okay, hypothetically, say Darien wins. Now they're 1-1. You know, fans are going to want a trilogy fight. Which organization is going to host a trilogy fight?
ね、ちょうど中間地点のハワイぐらいで。
maybe we can take the middle and then do something in Hawaii.
で、1ラウンド目ドローして、1ラウンド目ケージとリング組んどいて、どっちかで1ラウンド目2ラウンド目でこうです。
Maybe we can have both cage and ring set up, and then we can draw from a hat and see which platform rules we do for the first round.
Is there any interest in potentially doing a tournament with a mix of Ryzen and Bellator fighters in the future? Has that ever crossed your mind?
そうだね。もちろん僕らとしては今年もライト級のグランプリを秋からスタートしようと思います。そこには本当にベラトルのまでがなくてね、ベラトルのを代表する選手も出てきてほしいと思うし、僕らはサッカーでいうとこのチャンピオンズリーグにしたいと思ってるんで、これはまあ本当に世界中の大中小関わらずプロモーションを代表する選手たちをピックアップして格闘技界のチャンピオンズリーグみたいなものをやりたい。そこでベラトールの代表する選手にはぜひ出てきてほしいと思ってます。
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the idea for this year is to hold a lightweight Grand Prix this year, starting August, and hopefully it would be great to have a Bellator representative fighter in that Grand Prix as well.So ultimately, our goal idea is to put on the Champions Leagues of MMA. So we hope to have many fighters from proudly representing their countries and promotions to participate in the tournament.
One of the fighters who's done a lot of crossover was King Mo, and he just retired from MMA the other day. Do you have any thoughts on his career and kind of what he meant to MMA and his ability to fight between organizations?
まあでも、今後はもうやらないんでしょう、試合はね。だから本当に、まあ、彼は本当、日本でここの MMA のキャリアをスタートしたってこともあって、彼自身がやっぱり日本に対して特別な思いがあったっていうのが一つ大きかったと思います。だから、まあ、本当にこのキングモーという選手のように日本で戦うことにも抵抗はなくね、戦う特別な思いを持って戦える選手がベラトルにいたってことは僕らにとってはとてもこの2つのプロモーションが交流する上ではね、団体が交流する上ではラッキーだったかなと。
I think the fact that King Mo was a Bellator fighter, which made his professional debut in Japan, and who had a special place in his heart in Japan.A fighter like that being under the Bellator roster definitely helped us with this starting the first step towards this movement. So, having a fighter like that had a special place in Japan and who was fighting the Bellator, that was definitely a great way to start off this momentum.
Madison Square Garden is universally recognized as one of the biggest and most important sporting venues in the world. How do you and your fighters feel about not only coming to America to showcase your talents, but also to the world's most famous arena?
本当に光栄に思います。だから本当、まあ、僕自身もマディソンスクエアガーデンで、自分のところの、ね、代表選手を代表して送り出せる、それがマディソンスクエアガーデンであるってことだけでも、他のアリーナよりも何倍も興奮してる。 し、まあ、本当にここで最初にキックオフ、あのライジンの選手がアメリカでスタートする試合をすることがキックオフできるということを本当に嬉しく思うし光栄に思います。
It's a definite honor for us to be able to、kick off the Japanese fighters fighting in the United States、starting off at the Madison Square Garden. It's an absolute honor, and for me myself, being able to send our fighters to a U.S. promotion、to Bellator.For that, starting off at the Madison Square Garden is something that's very exciting for me as well.
Well, one championship,
yes.
One championship announced that they are opening up offices in America, possible events in America. He's done events with Pride in America. Any chance we see a rising event in America or an office in America? And a TV deal in America?
Well, in the future, really,アメリカが本当にこのスポーツをやっぱりスポーツとしてこのミックスマーシャルアーツってものを育て上げた国の、まあ、ナンバーワンなんです。ナンバーツーは日本だと僕は思ったんですけど、生まれたのがアメリカで育てたのが日本で、その後またアメリカで大きくしてっていう。だからそのもちろんアメリカという国は僕らのにとってもライジンにとっても憧れの国だし、なくてはならないマーケットだと思って、そこにはでも大切、あの本当にアメリカで僕らが一回だけ思い出作りにやるってことはできるけど、そんな意味がないので、やっぱりしっかり戦略と準備をしてパートナーをしっかり見つけて、もっと力をつけてから本格的にアメリカには上陸したい、僕らの一つの目標、あの大きな数年先の目標ではあります。
So how I look at MMA is that United States created MMA. Japan made it bigger, and then the United States finalized it and made it into a complete sport. So with that all being said, we do believe that United States is, America is an essential market for the sport. And obviously, being a promoter, we would like to come into this market is something very important. However,we can't just do a one-off just to say that we did it. If we're going to come in, we have to strategize and we have to find the right partner and be ready for us to come into the United States market. So, but yeah, that's definitely one of the goals that we have as a
group. All right, thank you.
Thank you.